Hey, what's going on, guys? Today, I'm going to show you guys how to remove the rear sprocket of this go-kart. It should be the same or slightly different for each kart manufacturer, but they're pretty much similar concept. Actually, I'm trying to take this piece off because I'm buying another go-kart. So this got to go to another rear sprocket. But I wanted to show you guys how to remove this. So just in case if you guys are let's say you wanted to change your axle to like a hard or soft type, you know, you're trying to get a different effects on your rear end, yeah, you know, this definitely relevant to that. So like I said, I'm here to show you guys how to remove it. And before we do that, I'm gonna show you guys what tools you need. So be right back. All right, now we're back. So, shout out to Eric, my kart tuner. He showed me how to remove the rear sprocket. I didn't know how to do it, so now I know how. So that's what I'm gonna show you guys. So, enough talking. First step, let's mark our hubs and brake holders, especially the hubs. These and on this end right here. So as you can see, you already have a line there, because I removed this once, this rear sprocket. So we're gonna mark that just so that we know when we put it back together that we know where to stop, like this hub, this wheel hub. So we're just gonna mark here. You can never have enough markings, right? So there you go. This is to ensure that when you put it back, you know where it needs to go. I'm not marking here because I'm taking this off. So that's the first step. And then it doesn't matter which piece you start loosening and removing, as long as you are able to remove. So this is the cassette screw. We're gonna take this off first. So let's get started on that. Alright guys, once you remove all the set screws, do not lose them because they can easily be lost. You can see how small they are. So try and keep them together. And yeah, these are, I lost a couple before, so that's how I know. Up next is you can remove the wheel hubs. So let's do that. So once we remove the wheel hub from this side, it's going to be similar on this end. So as you can see, I just loosen this all the way, this screw, and then
you just hammer it out, because sometimes this piece right here is pretty, it gets really hard to take off because all that build up there from the dirt and whatnot. So make sure you don't lose this piece right here, right? So it goes in there because there's that, just a little piece there that goes in there. So do not lose this, very important. Took off two of the wheel hubs. Now it's just removing this, the brake, hub, and then removing this, the actual brakes on the mounting, so that we're able to hammer this portion of the rear axle so we can push it out. All right, so let's get to it. So first we're gonna loosen this. So as you can see on this one, I already loosened them, so you can almost freely move this. So now we're gonna use this 1/2 socket with a small ratchet, and we're gonna basically remove the brakes so we can pull it, hang it, and then now we're able to hammer or push this rear axle. So once you remove those two screws, you want to make sure you hang these brakes just so that you don't have it just laying around, hanging on the this piece.
Once you have the brakes removed, all you gotta do now, like I said, is just push this whichever way you're gonna push the rear axle. That's pretty much the final step in removing the rear axle. So let's do that.
As you can see here, we're almost done hammering away. But yeah, this is the hardest part of removing the rear axle. So let's just keep going. Some cases you can pull this Let's see if we can try and pull it out. Nope. Not yet.
All right. So, yeah, you can pull this if you're able to. But if not, then you just keep pushing out all the things that you have on the rear axle until you get it off completely. So, let's do that.
So now, all you gotta do is hammer this out. Or actually, you can pull the whole thing. Yeah. All right. Oh. There you have it. We completely removed the rear axle, so now you can do whatever you want. You can put it back, or put a new rear axle. And yeah, so there's gonna be a second part for this video where I'll put this rear axle back. Oh, I might put a new one in there, you never know, but that's for the next episode that I'll be putting out, so be on the lookout for that. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope you guys subscribe and like the video. If not, thumbs down. If you don't like it, that's fine with me. But yeah, there you have it. How to remove the rear axle of the go-kart. Thank you, and I'll see you guys soon.